My name is Piero Basso. I'm a cinematographer from Italy, but based in New York, and I'm the chair of the cinematography program at New York Film Academy in New York campus. There are two peep show scenes in Paris, Texas. The first one where he goes and finds Natasha Kinski, his former wife, but he doesn't reveal himself, and then he goes back again after he decides to do what he's gonna do at the end of the movie. And so the second time, the light is very different from the first one. The first one, he drives a blue car, following the car of the wife, which is red. He enters through a door that is literally in the Statue of Liberty on a blue wall, goes into a room where there is a green light from a fluorescent, but then up the stairs, it's a brilliantly red light that leads into a door where the club basically is. And the club is again red, blue, white, until the moment he sees her. And the moment he sees her, he's walking into the green light. And he's walking into the green light because the green light is really a distressed emotional moment that he's living. He's trying to rebuild a life, but on the other hand, he's still not feeling completely into that dream. He's not ready. And if he doesn't talk to her, when the guy tells him that the place is closed, he walks away. At that point, she turns around to see him, which is one of the most beautiful shots, I think, of the movie. And he goes into the peep show. The color of the room are, again, red, white, and blue. There is no real connection between the two worlds. He's gonna leave. But the next time when he comes back, everything changes. There's no more green. The colors are real. You have Harry Dean Stanton lit by a simple light on the face, on the other side of the glass. And the only way that Nastasia has to see him is to turn off every light in the room, because this way the mirror is not going to be a mirror anymore, but now it becomes a glass. She can actually see him. And I feel like that is a very powerful metaphor, if we accept it, of the way Robbie Mueller sees lighting. He sees the light is what is needed to see reality, and sometimes reality is visible only when you are very careful in what you light and how you light it. I wonder if the approach that he had of that scene was, you know, we have two people, these two people are separated by their past, and the only way to break that barrier is to decide not to look at that past anymore and to start to consider what the future can be. And the only way to do that is to slowly take away the light from that past and let it go into the darkness, let it go away, let it drift, you know, whatever rancor, whatever pain, whatever sufferance, and also whatever beautiful memories that were there, let them go and start to look forward. And so for Natasha Kinski, instead of seeing the back, which is reflected in the mirror that she's looking in, you know, herself, but also the back of the room, she needs to see him. And on the other hand, at the beginning of the scene, Harry Dean Stanton turned around the chair. And he turned around the chair to look the opposite direction because he doesn't want to talk looking at her. And so in some way, he as well is not ready to face the reality that he's past that barrier. And only later on, he finally finds the energy, the strength, the power to turn around the chair and to, in some way, transition from a third-person story to the first-person story that is not telling about these two people anymore, but is talking about her and him. He's like on a stage performing for her to make her understand that she needs to let go, as he is doing, so that they can find in the middle. I feel like the end of the scene is incredibly powerful because the way that sequence ends when she's seeing him, but then she can't sustain the sight of him and she has to sit down and basically, again, looking far away from him. And he's, you know, above her, across this glass, which now doesn't exist anymore because the glass is not really reflecting almost anything. And, you know, they're talking, but you can feel that this conversation is between two people that are strangers. When before, you have the feeling and you wonder, like, why he makes the decision that he makes after all is done to try to rebuild the thing. And now you know it. Now you know that that was the only option. There was no rebuilding unless he takes the high route and decides for his son to let go and let her be with the son, which he desperately needs, and to look from the street, this window, where they are, and then decided to roll over to the horizon in some way, like the film starts. At the beginning was a desperate man, that lost hope and went to the desert, and now he feels like he's a realized man that has seen what the future will be, and so he's going away because he sees that this future is, in some way, there is a hope, there is a dream. It's in some way is the American dream, the end of the Party Texas.